Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. Nearly Senior Citizen here. Greetings, boys and girls, and welcome to this, another reaction video. Yes, indeed, another reaction video. And today is Wednesday, correct? Is it? Is it Wednesday? Today is Wednesday. It is the 11th of July. And it being Wednesday, it's Nostalgia Wednesday, wherein I react to a song from my youth. I consider my youth to be anywhere from 1962, the year I was born, to approximately 1989, when I was about 28. That's when my brain finally set and matured. So, during that time, when I was in the Air Force, from 1982 to 1986, the group, Art of Noise, came out with their first album in 1984. I bought that. I can't remember why. They had this song on it. Now, I've also bought their second album, which was, I've forgotten the name of it. What was the name of it? Well, anyway, that one came out in 1986. But this one came off of their first album, Who's Afraid of the Art of Noise, with the song Close to the Edit. Now, this is poor quality video. I mean, it's 20-something odd years old, so it's in 4:3 aspect and it's fuzzy, so I'm sorry about that. But the important part is the musical part, and that part's gonna sound at least okay, and that's good. Definitely a thumbs up. Now I'm gonna talk about the top of this video. I'll talk about the top of every reaction video. I have to, physiological reasons. If I could wait, if I could pause, I would. I can't. I have to talk over the video. So I do. So please, take a seat, strap in for safety. And please enjoy the show with me. And thank you very, very much for coming along. It is greatly appreciated. Definitely a good thing. Excuse me. So, let us watch. Let us listen to. Let us enjoy. And let us react to The Art of Noise, Close to the Edit, right now. By gum and by golly. I gotta turn it way up. It's so quiet. These older videos. Don't worry, I'll adjust the volume for you on your side. Such a weirdly shot. Like they took frames of a video out just to make it choppy. Which they probably did. Art of Noise was, may still be, odd. They used a lot of non-musical stuff in their music, as well as just plain music in their music. I mean, there's not a lot that I can actually critique about it music-wise or video-wise. I mean, this came out in 1984. There's nothing I can say about it that would could possibly be of use. I mean, who knows if they're even all still alive right now. But for just for a sheer appreciation of the sound and sheer appreciation of the bizarreness of the video, and thank you for coming along with me on this journey of exploration. Because I really liked this music back when I went into the Air Force when I was 19, got out at 23, and this sort of thing was big on my youth. Now, before I went in, I used to listen to only things like David Bowie and Pink Floyd. And then I got introduced to this sort of stuff, on top of, like, Devo and the like. But we didn't listen to this. We listened to Devo beforehand. And then I discovered this sort of stuff while I was in the service. I don't even know if they even had a point, just sort of avant-garde post-capitalist Dadaism for the sake of post-capitalist Dadaism. Nothing wrong with that, though. Although the poor piano, one would hope that they got one that was, like, due to be thrown out or had been thrown out and instead of taking a good piano and just destroying it. Off of this album, the consensus is that this is the only song on there, by what I've read on the internet, that really holds up off their album. If you like this sort of stuff, of course, you like the whole album. It's been a long time since I've heard the other songs on this one, though. I've listened to the other one much more. They had the Max Headroom actor in it. At least they're not cooking and eating the dog. Although that, once again, very, very odd and strange video. And the whole album is bizarre like this. I mean, it's... for the time, it was very bizarre. I mean, it's more tame now, the sound and all. I mean, even the group Yellow, which I really, really like, sort of surpassed and supplanted them on the actual avant-garde edge. But still, you know, they were a good basis and foundation for everything that came past them. So as the start of a movement, that's a good thing. Definitely a thumbs up. I can only hope that you enjoy that even half as much as I did. I, of course, have the rose-tinted sunglasses of nostalgia to look through, and so, of course, everything looks nice to me. But still, I can only hope that at least it sounded entertaining to you, if not actually good. Here's hoping it was actually good as well. Now, if you could check out my various links, that would be awesome. I have Twitter, Facebook, GoFundMe, Patreon.com, Google Plus. If you could donate to my GoFundMe campaign or become a Patreon.com patron, that would be awesome. Greatly appreciated. Your Patreon.com patron people are the reason I have a roof over my head. You're the reason I can keep paying rent. It is appreciated. Thank you very much. But if you cannot donate, or you simply do not donate, I do take all good wishes. I deposit them in the bank of my heart, where I draw interest. I am overloading my color filter like mad. There we are. I think it's like up and down like this to do it. Yep, look at that thing go. Oh, Logitech. Anyway, though, if you could toss me a like, that would be cool. I do appreciate all the positive validation I get from my existence. Definitely a good thing. And if you could subscribe to the channel, that would be cool. I would greatly appreciate it. I would understand if you don't want to. But if you are down with it, I will do my best to keep you entertained from now until the literal end of time. Definitely a thumbs up. I also have a game channel. Links are down below. If you could check that out, it would be awesome. I really need to get that monetized. So if you like watching an older guy play video games. Plus, if you've ever wondered where, if you like watching the Let's Plays I have down below, and you go like, how come this video goes 9, 11, 14? That's because the ones out of order are over on the game channel. So you might want to follow those. But hey, that was still a good video. A very good song. And again, I sincerely hope that you enjoyed that even half as much as I did. Sure, there was no chair dancing. Who needs to chair dance during something like... you don't need to chair dance if you don't want to. That's the thing about free choice, free will, decisions, and your own will. Your own will, your own choices. If you want to chair dance, please do. Never feel obligated. Definitely a thumbs up. So hey, I'm hoping to have a game video for this channel, hopefully a game video for the game channel. Hopefully, I need to get live streaming again. But with the heat, I keep falling asleep, and I'm so sorry. Ugh. So, you take care. Have a great day today. I will see you on the flip side. And I might as well say this too, of course, that I've got an Amazon wish list. If you could check that out, if you wanted to support me in some fashion that didn't exactly involve sending me money. It's got all sorts of stuff, candy, hamster food, all the way up to fans, to PlayStation 3. So no matter where you are on the financial stability spectrum, from good to bad, if you wanted to check it out, that'd be awesome. do not feel obligated. I do not feel entitled. And of course, I'm partnered with Humble Bundle. That would be cool if you could check that out. I have been paid by them once. Once in like the 6 months I've been shilling for them. So if you could purchase something on the link, if you like to purchase software, don't feel obligated, of course, that would be cool. They've got games, they've got development software, they've got books, ebooks. It's all really cool. So thumbs up and check it out if you'd like. Again, do not feel obligated. Thumbs up for that. So you take care. Have a great day today. I will see you on the flip side. And that, my friend, is a very good thing.